Hello friends, I am Ritraj Singh Tomar from International Institute of Professional Studies DAVV Indore. Today in this video lecture, I will explain you about operator overloading in C++. After this video lecture, you will learn what is operator overloading and we will look one example of overloading of binary operator. Now first let us look operator overloading. When an operator is overloaded with multiple jobs, it is known as operator overloading. It is the way to implement compile time polymorphism. Any symbol can be used as function name varied in C language but preceded by operator keyword. We can't overload size of ampersand and question mark operators. Now let us look one example in Dev C++ to understand operator overloading. Here we had made one class of complex type. In this class, we had taken private members, real and imaginary, and two public functions, void set data and void show data. In void set data, we had passed two arguments, integer x and integer y. Then we had assigned the value of x to the real variable and value of y to the imaginary variable. In show out function, we had just written one cout statement in which will print value of real and imaginary. Then in main function, we had made three objects of complex type. Then we had called set data for C1 object and passed arguments 9 and 8. Then we had called C2 object. Then we had called set data for C2 object and passed 6 and 5 as an argument. Then we had written C3 equals to C1 plus C2. Then we had written C3 plus. Then we had called show data for C3 object. When we will run this program, we will get an error. C3 equals to C1 plus C2 because here compiler after looking compiler to this plus operator, it will try to find plus operator's definition. Compiler knows how to work if both operands are of primitive type, but here there are non-primitive operands, therefore it doesn't know how to add them. That's why we will get an error. Now let us try one different form. Let us call 8 function here and pass C2 as argument. So we have to make some changes. 8 function here and pass C2 as argument. Understand this line very carefully. What I have told here, C1 is calling 8 function in which C2 is passed as an argument, and what 8 function is written will assign to C3. Observe that what I told you. C1 has called 8 function. It means this 8 function is a member function. So it must be in class. So we will in this 8 function. So we will make this 8 function in class. In this 8 function, we are passing C2 as argument which is of complex type. So we'll pass an argument of complex type. Here C3 will assign only when it will return complex type value, so its type will be of complex. Then we will define this 8 function. Here we will make one temp name object of complex type. In temps real, we will assign real plus c.real. In temps real, we will assign real plus c.real. And in temps imaginary, we will assign imaginary plus c dot imaginary and return the temps value. Here we had written temps which is this real which is of caller object, and this c dot real which is of C2 object. Understand this line very carefully. Temp.real equals to real plus C.real. We had written real, which is of color object, and C.real, which contain data of C2. Understand this line. Temp.real equals to real plus C.real. This line will give us result as addition of C1's real and C2's real and store its data in temp.real. Similarly for imaginary also. Here temp has stored both the value. After that we will return temp's value, which will show the result of C3. Now let us run this program once. Compile. Here we get result real equals to 15 and imaginary equals to 13. Now let us make some changes here. Can we change the name of this add function to sum? Yes, we can. Can we change its name as plus operator? No, we cannot, because function name can have alphabet digits and underscores and cannot contain any other symbol. It cannot be a function name. But in C++ we have provided with one benefit, that if we want to use any operator symbol as function name, we can use it by writing operator keyword. So we will make here some changes by writing operator keyword. So we will make changes in here also. So we can call this line be like this: C1 dot operator plus. Now let me run this program. We will get the result real equals to 15 and imaginary equals to 13. What we had learned here, that this plus operator has more than one meaning. In C language it can only add primitive type values, but here we had given one new meaning which will work only when these operands are of complex type. Here plus has more than one definitions, therefore it is the example of operator overloading. This is known as operator overloading. We can also write this C3 as, let me mention this as comment, and we can also write C3 equals to C1 plus C2. This is an example of binary operator. Now let me run this program. Is there any error? No error. We get result equals to real equals to 15 and imaginary equals to 13. So guys, this is the video lecture for operator overloading in C++ with an example of binary operator. Thank you guys for watching this video.